A variety of tailor-made, workflow-specific workspaces have been introduced to help new users get accustomed to the suite faster and easier. It also includes a collection of specialized workspaces that are designed to help you increase your productivity. And we've worked closely with professional industry experts who routinely use the CorelDRAW graphic suite to arrange tools and features for specific tasks such as page layout and illustration. What do we mean when we talk about workspaces? A workspace is a configuration of settings that specifies how the various command bars and buttons, dockers, and tools are arranged when you open the application. You can choose a workspace from the welcome screen that displays when you first launch the application. Or you can switch to a different workspace from within the application by clicking on Window, Workspaces. Using one of the specialized workspaces in CorelDRAW or creating your own custom workspace will make the tools that you use the most often readily accessible. If you are new to CorelDRAW, the light workspace is ideal for getting started. This workspace makes CorelDRAW's most commonly used tools and features more easier to find and use. In comparison with the other workspaces, the light workspace encourages exploration and only displays the essential tools for getting started. Let's take a quick look at some of the available tools. The light toolbox includes shapes such as the rectangle and ellipse tools, which let you create basic shapes. Also included are the effects tools. For example, the drop shadow tool, which lets you interactively apply a drop shadow to an object, and a transparency tool. These tools are great for creating artistic effects to shapes and text. As you explore with this workspace, you can also access additional tools and settings. It's so simple with the new Quick Customize buttons, which have been added to the Toolbox, Property Bar, and the Dockers panel. Quick Customize allows us to quickly add or remove items, customizing CorelDRAW to suit our own particular needs exactly. Let's quickly add a couple of additional tools. We'll add the Zoom flyout menu and the Artistic Media tool. Let's just quickly create a new object using the Artistic Media tool that I have just added to my toolbox. Next, I'm going to remove a setting from the property bar that I probably won't be using and add one that I will. Finally, I'm just going to take a quick look at my Dockers panel. And using the Quick Customize feature again, I'm just going to go ahead and make a couple of changes here too. I'll add alignment and dynamic guides, the font playground, and insert character. And here we have our new Dockers arrangement. If you feel that you have gotten used to the application features using the light workspace, you can try the other workspaces that will suit your level of expertise and workflow. Let's close this document now and take a look at one of the more advanced workspaces. Let's choose the Page Layout workspace. The Page Layout workspace is optimized for arranging graphics and text objects. So so you can create compelling layouts for business cards, branding materials, product packaging, or multi-page documents such as brochures and newsletters. And we can see straight away that the configuration of our property bar and toolbox has now changed and that we have many more tools to choose from. The layout toolbar has also been configured to show more layout commands which you can easily access and change. Not only can we decide ourselves which features to include in our workspace, we can also arrange toolbars and dockers over a single or even multiple monitors, so that we can work with these in a way that suits us perfectly. For example, by right-clicking here on this toolbar, I can remove the check from Lock Toolbars. This will allow me to move the toolbox, for example, over here to the right, next to my color palette. Or, if I was working with dual monitors, for example, I could drag my toolbars and dockers over to the second monitor and reserve my main screen just for the design itself. It's also possible to undock our documents by dragging on the tab. And again, these can be either taken over to a second monitor, or we can tile several open documents by using the tile commands from the window menu. Keeping the welcome screen open on the side will give you fast and easy access to all of the Graphic Suite's learning resources if you need any help along the way. Finally, don't forget, once you've completed your customization, just quickly go to the Window Workspace menu and save or export your new workspace so that it's readily available whenever and wherever you need it. Join us in our next training video for an in-depth look at the 7 essential learning tools that will get you up and running with CorelDRAW X7 in no time at all.